Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to use Twixter inside After Effects to create smooth slow motion, and here are some previews. So I will be showing you two methods, but the principle is basically the same. You can choose whichever that you are most comfortable with. So without further ado, let's get started. Previously, I have made a video to cover some basics of Twixter and how to choose your clip. And I will link that video in the description below in case you like to check it out. So here's the first method to prepare your sequence. We are going to enable time remapping by pressing Ctrl+Alt+T. Now we are going to create a keyframe at the beginning. Move one frame forward by holding the Ctrl key and press the right arrow key. Here we see that even though we moved one frame forward, the animation did not change. So let's move another frame forward. And now we see that the animation has changed. And we are going to place a keyframe here. So basically what you need to do is to go through the clip frame by frame and set a keyframe whenever there's a change in the animation. But before we continue, here's a quick tip. We can create shortcut for creating a keyframe, so you don't need to constantly create a keyframe by clicking on this icon. So go to Edit and Keyboard Shortcuts. Then in the search bar here, search Add Keyframe. And here I have already set the shortcut to be Ctrl and 1 on the number pad. But you can set it to any key that you like. Right, so now just go through the clip and create a keyframe when there's a change in the animation. Alright, now let's select all the keyframes. And let's go to the second frame position. Then while holding down the Alt key, click and drag the last keyframe until the second keyframe snaps the second frame position. You can zoom in to see that it's actually in position. And now when we play back, we can see that each frame has an animation. And we can trim off the extra sequence. Now right click on the sequence and pre-compose. Here we are going to select move all attributes into the new composition and also tick adjust composition duration to the time span of the selected layers. Click OK. Now we are ready to add the Twixter effect. So that is the first method to prepare your clips. And now I will show you the second method. And it's up to you to decide which one you prefer. Now for the second method, let's use this clip. And this method is more suitable when the number of frames between the animations are inconsistent. So similar to the first method, we're going to go through the clip by holding down Ctrl and pressing the right arrow key. So whenever there's a change in the animation, we are going to split the layer by pressing Ctrl-Shift-D. So here's the change. After that, we are going to select all these layers. And it's very important that you select the bottom layer first. And then while holding Shift, select say to frame number 4 time remapping mode, and we can delete the keyframe for the speed percentage, and before we start doing any keyframing, let's go into the sequence. And we are going to count the number of layers. In this case, we have 30 layers. So the total number of frames would be 30. And if you have keyframes, then you would count the number of keyframes. So let's create a keyframe for the frame number. And then go forward in the timeline and create another keyframe by typing in 30. So frame 30 is a black frame. So let's adjust that to 29. And now you can drag this keyframe to extend the duration of the sequence. And this method, I think of it as a combination of the previous two methods, because you have control over the keyframes, and also you know exactly which frame numbers is showing what. So those were the methods for how you can prepare your clips and slow them down using Twixtor. In the next video, I will go into the techniques of adjusting the speed and value graph in the graph editor for the keyframes. So stay tuned for that and subscribe to the channel.